Jess's Playground presents Wednesday Night Extreme.
Welcome to Wednesday Night Extreme. My name is Slim GK and Alison Parker will be with us when I need her. And tonight, to kick off the show, we have The Natural taking on a mystery opponent. So I did tell the Extreme Champion before the show he will have a mystery opponent tonight. But he has some few words to say for all of us. So let's hear it.
JPG Universe. I am the JPG Extreme Champion. And when it comes to it, I'm willing to fight any and everybody. I don't back down from no challenges. Nigga, I had to start off from this shit from the bottom to get all the way somewhere to the top. Now look at me. I'm a motherfucking champion now. And as me, as a champion, I'm at champion status. So I have to handle championship business. So I'm simply just going to say it straight up. Whoever wants some, come get some. I'm all about the smoke, and this is not a joke, and I'm ready. So come on, let's get this shit going. Let's go, bitch.
Oh, buddy. Well, this is going to be a challenge for the champ. If you don't know about this guy, let me give you a brief description. This dude right here is escorted by police officers for the sheer fact of killing someone in the ring. Accidental or not, no one knows. But all I know is this. He's answered the champion's challenge and is making his way to the ring.
And I'm locked up, I rep two sets, so I'ma ride and die and stay deep blocked up. Two toothbrushes up, whoever wanted would pee. When I walk by, get up, cause I'm locked up, they can't get me out. I smoke a stick of when they stress me out. Go and hit the bar when the red.
And here we go, the mystery opponent tonight has been confirmed as none other than Luke Warlock. The champion's trying to go for a chop, going for the second, and it's blocked off, and look at that for a chop. Sending the champion into mid-air. The power from this guy is unexplainable. It's not human. If you picture the Hulk, that's this guy 10 times over. He is a wrecking ball machine. Not many people have defeated this guy. One simple move can put you away. Already the spear nearly putting the champion away, but kicks out at two. The Natural has got a big, big challenge ahead of him here tonight. And now Warlock, twisting the wrist and picks up the champ. Crashes him down on that steel mat. And strikes down as well. And a stomp to the midsection, calling him up and then stomping him back down. The Natural already in trouble and the bell has only just been rung. The match has only just begun. And now he's targeting the ankle there and just sweeping him down. Do you know what? I have never seen anyone more powerful than Warlock. He has dominated every single opponent that steps foot inside that ring against him. And the Natural's got a big challenge ahead of him. Back on the offense, the Natural now going for the middle ropes with the drop kick, sending the big man down. Can the champion defeat this man, defeat this monster in a non-title match? Going for the clothesline, Unlock didn't even barely move. Oh, and a clothesline from behind as well. Now throwing him into the top left corner, the Natural eating that punch. Another clothesline, this one from the front. And now just showing off his strength, Warlock. Look at the size of him. His veins, literally bigger than a human finger. Kick to the gut from Warlock. Then twists him around face first into the steel. This is an extreme rules match, but I don't think Warlock needs any sort of weapon. He's a weapon of his own, spine buster to the Natural. Now, don't know what the Natural was thinking about challenging anyone from Wednesday Night Extreme, especially when this man is involved. I understand he's a fighting champion and he wants to prove himself even more, but he's got nothing else to prove. He's already got the gold. I would have just took it and ran, especially if this guy's staring down at me. And now again with the second slap over the head. The Natural and Warlock's begging him to get back up to his feet to bring it on. And if I was him, I'd stay down. And here he comes with his second spear. Going for the pin again, and the referee starts to count with the 1, 2. It's a kick out at 2, Natural. If I was you, buddy, I'd stay down. This man does not play around. The guy's killed someone in the ring. There's a reason why those police did not let him come to the arena alone. Throwing him out the ring now and just loving the fans and just showing off his physique. And what's the Natural doing? Warlock too busy taunting around, and the Natural's brought in a ladder into play. I don't think Warlock realizes it. Oh, he does. And the Natural with the strike. And Warlock, not happy with that one. Irish whip into the ropes and a boss man slam on top of that ladder. The only ladder that the Natural brought into play in the cover now. And 3, no. A kick out at 2 again by the Natural. And we've seen this before. The thumbs up, thumbs down. He's going to call for the finish. Going to throw him into that bottom right corner. And he calls this one the prison ball. Bam! Oh, and the back of the head lands and connects on the corner of the ladder. He's not done. The Natural getting picked up by Warlock, and he's just squeezing the living shit out of him with the bear hug. Natural frantically trying to get out of there, but it's got nowhere to go, nowhere to hide, and he's got to tap out. My God, made him look like nothing. And your winner, Luke Warlock. Tells me the Natural isn't going to forget about this night. Maybe this isn't the last time we see these two face off, but I can confirm Luke Warlock will face the Natural for his Extreme Championship at the Rumble pay-per-view. But coming up next for the second match tonight, we have KJ taking on Gun Militia member Angelo. This guy right here, Angelo, a member of the Gun Militia, could have been one half of the tag team champions with his tag team partner Travis Carter. Now we all saw how that turned out. But tonight he will face off with a former Universal champion, KJ Felipe. He lost that championship against his own friend, former brother, Zack Storm, who also lost at the pay-per-view when his own brother, Victor Tolos, cashed in his Jester's briefcase. Become not only the Vengeance champion but the Universal champion, and still holds 2 of those titles today. This match is going to be good. Go, the ring of the bell has been heard by both men, and we are about to kick this off with a grapple from Angelo. Gets kicked off by KJ, suffers with a punch, a slap, another punch, and a back fist straight towards Angelo. And now big knee from Angelo, retaliating and calling up KJ for more. KJ going with the strike, there's the other punch, there's the second, there's the third, and a big drop kick to knock down Angelo. The man you see toting around with the fans was one of the best underdogs to live up to become a big dog, until his own brother, as mentioned, Zack Storm, took all that away from him. Not known if he's forgiven Zack for his actions, but what I do know is he's ready to prove himself and to become one of the best again. And Angelo is his hurdle to cross over. Angelo with the grapple throwing him into the bottom right corner. There's the kick, there's the second. KJ under the midsection, but suffers with a backstabber from behind from Angelo. Angelo picking up his opponent now with the grapple, going for a lovely suplex there into the cover, but the rope break has been seen by the referee. Angelo again picking up KJ. KJ kicks him off, big running forearm to Angelo, running boot as well from KJ, but Angelo still kicking up, another running forearm from KJ, picking up Angelo now. Back on the offense, punch is missed and countered. Big knee from Angelo, calling up KJ again, back up to his feet, and KJ obliges. Big kick from Angelo, and Angelo's just called it. There's the finish. Cover now, two, and that is all she wrote. Let's check out that highlight one more time from Angelo to end the match quickly. Big spinning kick. All it took to put KJ down, out for the count for the 1, 2, 3. Quick match, quick work done by Angelo. Coming up next for match number 3, we have King Joshua taking on Justin Prince. This man has been an aggravating thorn for Eric Cruz. Constant attacks out of nowhere on that man. Both of those men have pure bad blood. No friendship at all. Pure enemies. Pure rivals. And I don't think that rivalry will be put to bed anytime soon. But tonight, Justin Prince is a king to deal with. Let's see how that plays out. Match number 3, King Joshua taking on Justin Prince. And here we go. Match is underway for match 3 of tonight. And already caught the strike. Joshua gets out of harm's way. And look at the vicious strikes in the midsection to the ribs of Justin. The King is not going to play around tonight, as he's going to go off with his head to Justin Prince. Look at King. Look at King. Oh, and look at Justin. Look at Justin clapping back. Joshua King trying to torment Justin there with his own Bullet Club taunt. And Justin just clapped back, and he's clapping back now with one German suplex. There's the second, and the King is in deep trouble. There's the third. My God, took him straight to Suplex City. And Justin isn't done. Picking up the King now. Just going to throw him over that top rope, lean to the outside. He plays around with the crowd. And now Joshua gets back in the ring. But look at Prince. Look at Prince going for that finish. And now for the cover. 1, 2. And look at Eric. Eric's here. Just getting involved in Justin Prince's match. And Justin can't believe it. Oh my God. taking down Prince. And Eric Cruz tossing him over that top rope and is not playing around with Justin's games anymore, picking him up and just going to throw him straight into that barricade. And Eric Cruz is definitely not going to play around with Justin anymore of his little games. Grabs the kendo stick and strikes the face of Justin. Now into the midsection and just smacking away with the kendo stick. Cruz sending a big message to Prince that he will not be walked over. He's definitely proved that one tonight. Unfortunately, that match has resulted in disqualification, but don't go anywhere. X has some words to say about what happened last week.
Last week, you all saw what I am capable of, but I got to let it be known. Wasp, who the hell do you think you are?
What in the fuck are you talking about?
I know you put something in that JD, and you can't be doing that shit.
It's not my fault you're such a lightweight. Didn't really seem to slow you down, though.
Because what you do is easy, and that belt is mine.
Now I know you must be high if you think you're taking this from me. I'm sorry you are so delusional that you think you're entitled.
Fuck you, insect. Go boof a pill, junkie.
I think I like where this is going.
Bring it on then, face paint.
Wasp is now charging down the ring. He's already in there. He's now Irish whipping X into the ropes. Big kick from Wasp, but X is still on his feet, leaned against the ropes. But another Irish whip from Wasp. Big kick again. And Marty X is still on his feet, just taking all this damage from Wasp. And Wasp is not giving up. Big running knee through the middle ropes, and there goes crashing down Marty X. X has re-entered the ring, and it doesn't look good for him. He's already getting picked up for the Get Fucked F5 from Wasp. These two have broken out control, and the lights have bloody gone off. And what's going on now? Oh man, turn around, Wasp. X is messing up with the electricity, and he's right behind you. Look at the shred of Marty X just picking him up by his bare hands and choking this son of a bitch. He's losing consciousness, Wasp. Trying to fight this lock, seeing stars now, and he has no idea where he's at. He's just lost consciousness, and X still holding onto that grip, and he's gonna have to chuck him down now. And Wasp rolling out the ring. Poor man. And look at Young Danger. Now he's came into play. Pure chaos at Wednesday Night Extreme, and there's only one way to solve it. I think this has got to be a triple threat match at the Jester's Rumble pay-per-view for the United States Championship. But coming up for our finale tonight, we have Angels of Sin versus Angels of Sin, Brothers versus Brothers, Chris Angel and Sean Alexander team up to take on the boss, myself, Slim GK and Victor Tolos. Before that though, let's get into a quick advert.
Hello folks, this is Alison Parker and I will be commentating over tonight's main event between Chris Angel and Sean Alexander taking on Slim GK and Victor Tolos. Now all of these men have bad blood, they have history, they were brothers, they were involved in Slim GK's team, the Angels of Sin, and I believe all of that has been put aside as they really want to rip the heads off of each other. JPG Intercontinental Champion Sean Alexander, Chris Angel, the British Heavyweight Champion, teaming up tonight to put their friend Slim GK in his place. Slim GK has mentioned, he uses this music, Thriller, by Michael Jackson, to intimidate his opponents. From the words of this song, they will try to scream, they will be paralyzed, it will be a thriller. And I am sure it will be, especially when the boss has got the demon right next to him. The Universal Champion, Victor Tolos. What a team this is. Over 700 pounds of pure destruction. This match is definitely main event worthy. Sean Alexander will take the lead for his team, as will Victor Tolos. Look at these guys just walking slowly towards each other. The anticipation, it is intense. Both men trying to out-strengthen each other with the grapples, but look at Tolos just throwing off Sean, and now with a running forearm. The demon not playing already, and he wants Chris Angel to get in here. And tag is made. Angel obliges to the demon. And Chris Angel is going to take on this masked man. The two-horned devil, but Victor Tolos just takes him straight down to the mat. Throwing him into the ropes now. And just caught him. Plants him down to the steel. I've got to say, Slim GK is very lucky to have a man like Victor Tolos on his side. Chris Angel with a reversal. Punch to the demon. Strikes. Knife is chopped into the corner. And now, throwing him to the other side of the ring as he runs towards him. Gets clotheslined out of nowhere from Tolos. And Tolos says, bring it on, Angel. See if you can do it again. And Chris Angel does. Now the kicks. Big knee to the face to Victor Tolos. Oh, and Tolos just taking down Chris Angel like he's nothing. And now Chris Angel kicking off the demon. Lovely moonsault there to Victor. Slim GK wants in, and Chris Angel's gonna let the tag be placed, and tag is made. Slim GK and Chris Angel will face each other at the Jester's Rumble pay-per-view, are now circling each other. And the boss, look at the strength of Slim as he places him down, just picked him up, and he's now shushing all the boos in the arena. Slim and Chris Angel were great friends, great brothers, and now that's all put to bed. No longer friends, no longer brothers. These guys are bitter rivals. Chris Angel with the combination of the punches and the dropkick to take down the boss. Chris Angel picking up Slim now. Throwing him into the ropes. Picks him up and places him down, and now levels him up for a jumping drop kick. To Slim. Slim kicks back up like it's nothing and stares down Chris Angel. Chris Angel with the punch gets reversed by Slim. Slim with the jab. Another jab was missed. Kicked to the gut from Angel. Angel misses with the punch and Slim fights back. And now the forearm. Kicked to the back of the head. Kicked to the gut. Kicked to the chest. The big spinning kick to the face of Chris Angel. And Slim GK is on fire. Slim picking up Angel. Throwing him into the corner towards Sean. And he's doing some thrust now, and Sean is tagged in. And Sean wants a piece of Slim. After what happened last week, Sean will not back down. After Slim made him tap out for the hide of Victor Tolos taking out the lights last week. Now Sean getting jabbed by Slim. There's the punch. Now picking up Sean, placing him down, and a lovely senton from the boss. As he goes up top now, Slim looking to fly. Going for the elbow drop, did not connect. Sean got out of the way just in time, trips him up. Now we've seen this before, the move that made Slim GK bleed last week. Can he do it again? Face first onto the steel, this time Slim does not bleed. Picking up the boss now with a strike, the kick. Now targets the arm with the knees. GK's in trouble. Look at the strength of Sean Alexander, the Intercontinental Champion, with a sail. Powerbomb going for the cover and only a one count. Slim kicking out at one, already back to his feet. And just pouncing on his good old brother, Sean Alexander. Picking him up, Sean in trouble. Gets thrown into the corner, and now a tag is made to his favourite demon, Victor Tolos. What's he thinking here? Oh, Slim, the disrespect. You guys used to be friends, but watch out. The cannonball splash to Sean from the big man Tolos, and he's just laughing at him. Chris Angel wants him, but Sean can't get to him in time. And now, single hand choke slam to Sean Alexander. Tolos turns his attention to Chris with the punch. What's he thinking here? Oh no, slamming the spine down onto that steel apron. Sean kicks up back to his feet, but big mistake there. Tolos throws him into the corner, and tag made again. The boss is in. And look at this, Thriller out of nowhere. Slim with the cover, that could be it, that could be all she wrote. Two, and Chris Angel got there in time, but did not break up the pin. Sean kicked out anyway. And Slim can't believe it. Sean, what would he have to do to beat Slim GK and Victor Tolos, both men? Strong in their own right, Sling Blade. A big left knee to GK as he goes for the cover. One, and only a one count again. You know, GK can be a dangerous person, especially when he goes to his dark place, when he becomes the Jester. And I think Sean wants that to happen as he goes to try and make him bleed like he did last week, with second time tonight. He does not make him bleed tonight. Slim feeling the effects of that move, but still manages to fight off Sean, running clothesline, and now stomping away his old friend. Now goes up top for the second time. Can he connect with this one? Yes, he can. Going for the cover. Tolos gonna guard Slim as he does, and only a two count. Chris Angel breaking it up, and Slim is pissed off as he goes to target Angel, and now he's gonna take one out of Victor Tolos's book, slamming his spine down onto the apron, the steel apron. Victor Tolos now throwing Sean back into the ring. The action takes place in the middle, and look at Sean out of nowhere with the Kinshasa to Slim. Going for the cover, one, not even a one. And now Sean trying to target Tolos, but Tolos isn't having any of it. That aids Slim. And
you end this match, I'll fire you. Keep it going.
She can hear Slim say, "Do not disqualify me, I will fire you," to a referee. Kick from Slim. And a super kick from Sean in retaliation. Slim gets back up to his feet, gets thrown into the ropes, gets popped up by Sean, and a code breaker out of nowhere. And now Sean takes out Victor. And now Sean going for the win. One. Wait, who's this? That's Gorilla Cruz. Sean has just broke up his own pin as he sees Chris Angel getting targeted on the outside by Gorilla Cruz. And look at Slim rolling out the way as Gorilla Cruz does the dirty work and slams down Sean. My God. Looks like this man has just joined the GM of the Jester's Playground and the Demon Victor Tolos. Thank you for joining us on Wednesday Night Extreme, and we will see you on Saturday Night Inferno this week. Don't miss it.
Wednesday Night Extreme.